again. You so well, but still I long to look. How's it going, folks? It's 3 o'clock, and I hope you are all safe and well. And I know that a lot of people out there have been either started sculpting or have been sculpting, and people have been sending me their stuff, which is cool. There's a few people who they were on to me, and they were saying they don't know where to start, or they don't know what to sculpt. Now, just excuse me, I'm trying to do a few things at once, as I usually am. I have Instagram, and I have Facebook, and over there I have YouTube. That's going out to the website. There's a few people who are not on social media at all. They asked me would I put it up, and I said I would. So I have 3 cameras on the go, as if 2 isn't enough. How are you, Aiden? How's it going? But a few people are saying that they don't know where to start, or that they don't feel that they're good enough to be able to start. And I think it is, it's not for shame to be thinking like that. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't, as long as people are, you know, sculpting anything. I know there's people out there who haven't gotten any either tools or materials. It doesn't really matter what we're sculpting, as long as we're doing something. Like this fella here, I think it's apt. I don't have the quote in my head. I think this quote, of course, is fail and fail better. Doesn't really matter if it's good. What matters is that you actually are doing it. So there's a few I've seen a few people already have posted stuff up to me. Paddy Hines out there doing the Skeksis. There's a beautiful dragon that was sent to me yesterday. There's Kieran. He's doing all sorts of stuff. Kieran Wren, and unfortunately it was for his nephew, and he said that. He was supposed to go to Australia, but unfortunately, there's no post to Australia at the minute. I think that's what he said. There's people doing loads of cool stuff out there, and people who didn't have materials now. People who didn't have tools. I think Aoife, she sent away, got tools, and not tools, but actual materials, followed the tutorial, and has made her own tools. So since I saw ye last, which was on, what day is it? Oh my God, I don't even know what day it is. It's Saturday. So on Wednesday, I flew into this a bit, and worked on his eye. His eye, the eyes were annoying me. And this here, I don't know which one it is that is, well, that's his left, that's his right. It's all confusing to you though. That one there, I'm getting sort of happy with it. This one, I'm not happy with it at all. I actually think I put the eye in the wrong place. I'm gonna work with it a bit more, and if I can fix it, I'm gonna pull it out, put it back in again. Don't particularly want to do that, but I want it right. And another one was that the texture is going in the wrong direction. I don't know, I got into it, and I just kept on going and didn't pay attention to my reference. And Lydia was shaving today, and you can see that the direction of the, especially when you smile, especially this kink that's here, pushes up this skin. So it gives you all these parallel lines going up into the ear, and then it shoots down from the ear. I didn't do that. So I'm going to work on this as well. I've done the back of the head, and done sort of these. He's old at this stage. This is when he was younger. It's the reference. I don't know if you see it behind me. He's younger. This here, it's folds of skin, and I'll work into that and make it look old. But what I've sort of tried to get done is the ear and the eye, and this side here. I'm sort of trying to mirror that side there, and get it equal. No, I know it's not equal, so I'm trying to get it equal. But I don't particularly like spending loads of time trying to get that done, whereas this is the nice side. And so I'll work on that. then I'll flip over to the other side when I'm my head's ready to do it. So, the last time, actually, I was working on this muscle. So I'm going to keep on working on that. I just saw that it's not the same as the other side. And I'm using this wee fella here. A handy yoke to have, one of him. And I have a skull in the background. He's also very handy to have. So it's this muscle here that's underneath the chin, going from the ear down into the sternum. So I'm going to work on that for a wee while. How is everybody out there anyway? Don't know about you, but this is getting to me a bit, not being able to get out a hell of a lot. And I've been talking to students and to be honest, not really talking to the work, more talking about just actually talking to have communication with people. Well, man, Umesh, how's it going? Umesh, this is familiar to you. You would have seen, I went to college with Umesh. We did a master's together. And I sort of started this fella off there. I didn't finish him there at all. But the idea was there, and my studio was passed from Beckett. This tool here is fantastic. And what I'm trying to do is I've built up sort of muscular, built up the clay. And what I like for the form, I wanted to, I'm not looking for smooth, but what I'm looking for is definition. I'm not looking for pits and falls all over the place. And I explained that last time. You see that there. When I drag that down, I'll be able to see a hollow. And maybe not with that. I'll try this. I'll show you this clip. You can when you scrape across with the loop tool, you will see darker spots and lighter spots. The darker spot is a hole. The lighter spot is the high point. And when you get to a stage that is all light, it's pretty much on one plane, and there's not divots going in and out. Now for this, I will be going in later on, and I will be going in with loads and loads of, this texture here is the first pass, so I'm going to be going with loads of texture. So the first thing I need to make sure is that there's no divots and there's no things that shouldn't be there. And it's not that I'm looking for a smooth, beautiful marble finish, but there should be a definition and a form, because if there's those divots in it, and what I mean by divot is little pits and holes that shouldn't be there. And once you start on the texture and you get onto the texture, to get to that stage, you spend an awful lot of time sculpting and get the form right. You will never ever get rid of those divots on the texturing phase, unless you actually get rid of it. But once you put the texture onto it, you'll always see that divot. And I thought this stage that I get rid of all that. Now you see that muscle there comes from underneath the skull. I like to, and you're not going to see any of this, but I like to put these parts of the skull in, so that muscle comes down here and across and around and comes up behind the ear. It comes down and around and goes into the sternum. Now, what I'm going to do today is just work on this area. I might go back into the eye because I was actually sculpting this morning, and it was just nice to get into, you know, get into doing something. So I was doing this at, I don't know, all hours of the morning. But the next thing I'm going to do is, I'm going to try and build off this shoulder. I'd like a sort of a sculptural plinth, classical plinth on them, but I'd like a little bit of shoulder on them. Now, to do that, you're not going to be able to see it now, but in on here is just tinfoil. So I'm just going to build up a tinfoil shape in on the shoulder. Now you can see that muscle again coming from up here, around, and down. Now this tool here, I bought it in Neil's Materials. I've sent that tool making tutorial out to YouTube. uploaded it. And so anybody can access that and have a look. But this particular one came from Neil's Materials. It's a beautiful tool. But all it is the KNS that I showed you and this banded metal. All that is a bandsaw blade. Now it's a brand new bandsaw blade. Good afternoon, Catherine. And Juan Giancarlo, I think that's how you pronounce your name. You're more than welcome to be here. That's just a bandsaw blade. Now it's a brand new bandsaw blade that's in it, but it's fantastic for doing this and getting it to the next level. Now, what I've noticed as well, I'm getting very thin in spaces. There you can see it. I'm just going to scrape this off. That's the right there, the tin foil. That's how thin that is there, and it's a bit too thin for me. So I'm just going to get rid of it. So, lads, I did a demo on Friday. There's a few up here that that saw that. It was doing a sort of painting silicone and trying to get it as real as possible. Now, I'm looking at it today and I probably could do another pass on it. But the next stage for it would be to actually hair punch. And if Damien, I think it's Damien from Fourth Year, he asked would I make a hair punching needle, and I said no problem. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a hair punching needle, and I'm going to show you how to hair punch into silicone. I'm going to use a sample that we made yesterday, and I'll probably do that on Wednesday. So as I said, if people ask me or want me to do some tutorials in sort of different techniques, if I can, I absolutely will. But there's certain things I won't be able to do, but under the circumstances. I'm gonna do that next Wednesday. The other thing I was thinking was there are people out there, and I think if this stops, I think the whole country's going to stop. We still have post, so if there were people interested, I'm going to make some tools. I've been making tools anyway, and if you're interested, I was going to put a post up and do sort of a wee competition. It's not a competition, but I'm gonna do a couple of sets of tools, and they're for free. Like this post, share the post, and I'll get my kids to randomly pick somebody out of it, and I'll post the tools off to you. So now, don't know how many tools I would get to make, but yeah, to make some. Hey, Gemma. Yeah, Catherine, I thought we needed some of the crooners today. So what are people sculpting, or are we just watching? Hi, Brian. So as I said before, with Instagram, like an hour, it's bizarre. An hour can just fly like that. Some people do stay for the hour, and it's cool. Some people just come in and out. But with Instagram, I can only do an hour. I don't know about you, but I find after an hour, I'm just getting into it, and I'll stay on for a wee while longer to get some stuff done. And Facebook, it'll let me do it a little bit longer. Oh yeah. With texturing, I forgot to say this the last time. With texturing, there are texturing tools, but there are texturing stamps we can make. And this was just I literally getting one of these for myself. You can see the texture on that. You sort of see the texture on that. You can see that it is sort of gnarly skin like, especially if we turn it around the opposite side. Now in there, that there is a crow's feet of around the eye, and that there, I don't really do it. I like to sculpt it, but people might want to do it. If you put latex on it, put and let the latex go off, and then get some tissue and put the, a layer of tissue on it, and put latex on it again, and do a few layers of that, and then talc it. Peel it off. Just trying to see if I got one. I have one somewhere. I'm trying to find it. You can use that and press it and impress it. They're called texture stamps. I don't really use them. I used to. Don't really use them anymore. The reason why I don't really like using it is because it's latex, and the silicone I like to use, it can get inhibited or it can stop from going off. And that is not a good thing, so I don't use it anymore. But that's no reason why you can't, why you couldn't. Now, some people said to me, yeah, but you could use silicone. Yeah, you could, but to be honest, I don't really bother with them anymore. But it's worth having a go. Doing a different kind of sculpt right now with plaster. What's the sculpt with plaster? Making a little creature that's a cross between a tangerine and a baby sloth. Love the orange texture idea. Yeah, you can get it. Oh, another good one is avocados. Like anything. We'll give you a texture. Oh, I think Clodagh might be out there. The capture doesn't matter. Whatever you want to sculpt it. But for Clodagh wants to do. I don't know if you know the character. Patrick Ness wrote a book. It's coming to me, Monster Calls, and the monster in it is actually, I think it's a willow tree, or a yew tree, and a yew tree comes to life and becomes this creature. She's going to try and actually make her own design of it. But what I was thinking, if you with texture stamps as well, years ago I did this, it was called a Moro, some fancy thing. But what we did was for the crack, we needed to be done quick. We went and we molded an gnarly tree in silicone, and then we melted wax. This is the Chivant. And poured it into the silicone, and we could actually then use them as part of the sculpt. Now, what I found was I couldn't really use them everywhere. It was great to cover up big spots, but then what was fantastic about it is it was brilliant reference. And I'm just trying to get this muscle in. It was absolutely fantastic reference, but I could use it as well to make it really quick. So I want the 40. Oh, Miniature Mountain at 1 to 40. Cool. Is that for something? Right. So anything could be used for textures. The fun bit, though, with the sculpting is figuring out how you could replicate that texture with tools instead of just molding and popping it out. But no harm in molding and popping out. Hey, Mayor. Now, this is the reason that I built one of my old tools. The ones that I showed the other day, I made about that size there. The reason why I like the short ones, which is that one there, like you can see, two reasons. That there, you can get two out of a K&S, which is that size. This, you get three, but it also it's nice for getting into awkward areas. Oh, Claudia, are there? Cool. Have a go. What you could do is, because you probably have it, get your Plat Gel 25. I was only thinking about this. It was literally when I was thinking about what would we talk about for textures. Just get some Plat Gel 25, find a tree, hopefully there's one near you that you can actually get to, and mold it. That's insane. Put it in. Like, even for the hand, you could use it for really gnarly knuckles. It's real handy way of getting texture. Oh, it's your final project, Brian. Okay. So I assume mod makers just are like design for stage and screen, still trying to, under the circumstances, create work. What I've noticed since starting doing this is I don't know, I think less and less people are on social media. When I was looking at the very beginning, you'd see, I know, 300 people out of all the people that I know online. People just so sick of stuff, and that we've overdosed of online stuff. I don't know, well, I certainly have. Louise, what's your final project? What are you sculpting? I can't remember what you said to me. Now, what I discovered as well, this is the thing with making armatures. This one here, I really quickly did it and didn't really think about it. And all it is there's a front profile of them cut out in MDF and a side profile cut out in the MDF, put it into an X shape. That's a really bad X, but an X shape. And the problem with that is that there's bits that actually aren't in the right place. That bit there isn't really in the right place. It's the sternum. And what I want to do is rip that out, and because that's going to be beautiful. That bit there, especially on dudes with the Adam's apple. I have a reference here, and you can see the sinew is going down into it, so that would be a nice one, but I have to get rid of that first, and I'm a little bit worried about it because he weighs a ton, so I might just scoop it out and not compromise the integrity of it. You're told to keep working even for portfolio purposes. Absolutely, isn't it? But what are we going to do? Nothing. So it'd be best doing something and use it for portfolio. All I'm trying to do is equal up. The general shape I want to equal up, but there's these, I don't know what it's called, turkey skin underneath the neck, and they do weird, wonderful things, so they don't necessarily follow symmetry. Like, they don't follow the same tree at all. Catherine, how's your eye? Catherine put super glue, or well, didn't put it in, accidentally put super glue in her eye. I was worried about you. Yeah, Paddy, symmetry is a pain. What are your eyes? What is his eyes made of? I thought you meant your eyes. So putting super glue in your eyes, you think, I just want to clarify that now. So putting super glue in your eyes, it makes your eyes out even better. I don't think you should publicize that. Yeah, Paddy, symmetry. Oh my God. And I will work on something. And sorry, my head going all over the bridge. I'm trying to look on the meanest chin. I will look on something and look some extra. And then I go away and I come back and say, what the flipping hell was I doing? Hey, Roshi. Gemma, are you still here? I just wonder, are you actually making something at the minute? Howdy doody. I say, what is absolutely amazing me is, I have this stuff in my house, so it's something that I regularly do. But there are people out there that aren't used to or don't have stuff in their home. But the creativity is staggering. What people have got up to. Jenny, what's the story? Oh, sorry, his eyeballs. The eyeballs. One here, a small one. I did have a small one. Where did I put it? Yeah, I knew I had one. So the eyeballs on this fella, now he's big, but these are for a normal size head. Humans are 24 millimeters in diameter, and this one is 28. I just find it easy to work with. That there is what's in the head. And now what's on the back, what's actually in the head, I'll show you that. Now what's actually in the head is that shape there. And that there is how you will buy the eyes, in that shape there. So this is actually the shape of an eye. And the bolt that is in there, that there, I took it out, it was in here, it was in my way. It can get in the way. But eventually this here will create a hollow in side of the mold, and when I pull this out, and because it'll be made in silicone or clay, I'll be able to pull it out. In the silicone to be left a hollow, and then I'll replace that with the normal eye. But what's really clever, I get these from Fort Seal in Los Angeles. Tim Currents makes them, and they're just brilliant. His work is just phenomenal. It's absolutely phenomenal. If you don't know that company, go and just look at their work. It's just art. I did a course with him as well, and it was fantastic, and really fantastic. we did hand painted lights. So when you put that in, now it's a little bit off. When you put that in, it now creates the shape of a ball. The eye, in making of the eye process, I'm not going to explain why, but there is always a, not always, but most of the time there is a flat back. But with that, there is a pain in the ass, because when you put the eye in, you can't move it around because it's got a flat back. This here creates a round, and when you put the eye in, you can move the eye around, so you can actually get the pupil focused in. The material that is polyurethane resin. I hope that answers the question. His name is Tim Currens, and the company is Fort Seal Studios in Los Angeles. Thank you, Christine. One look and I yell timber. Me yapping. And Christine, I wouldn't do anything like that. I would yap. The potatoes aren't cold. What I did before I started was the Chivant blocks. I've shown you them before. I had it in there, took it out, cut off into chunks, and so that sort of size chunks. They're all in there, and that there, you can see, it melts. But it's not. When it's glossy, it is lava, and will take skin. So it's not glossy, so that's funny. So what is everybody else sculpting? Stephen, what are you doing? Alex, how's it going? Stephen, you have to be doing something. Doesn't have to be sculpting though. You're watching me. That's lovely. Well, Kathy, how's it going? Kathy, you have to be making something at the minute. A big hairless cat. Oh, is that the one you showed me? The wrinkly one. Making it out of Chivant is no crack. I would have thought it'd be great fun. Balls and loads of sausages. That's what you want. Loads of sausages. And then blend them in on top of each other. What I've found, lad, it's actually, well, I can do it. I'm used to doing it. But I got up early this morning to battle into this a bit. I was sort of saying to a friend the other day, I picked Beckett, who's the hard enough, and I decided I would do this size, and Jesus, that's he's big. The smallest of areas, the smallest of details take that forever. People in here I don't recognize at all. So lad, what I'm trying to do, or what I'd love to do, what I'm trying to sculpt this fella, try and get as many people sculpting, so and distract them from what's going on at the minute. And actually, maybe we could create something really, really cool. Now, that I'm not happy with that eye, because I think he's completely wing-wang. That's a technical term, wing-wang. The hair make it the man, yeah, definitely. He had a do, and I have to say that's gonna be a pain to do, but it to actually get to that stage, thought that load of work would have been, I'd have gone through a bucket load of work to get to that stage. I have to finish sculpting them first, and then I will mold it, and then I will cast it, and then I will paint it, and then I will hair punch it. And somewhere in the middle, I have to think about the stand of what he's going to stand on, and possibly make a core. Wasn't thinking of a better core. I was thinking of just slushing him because he's huge. Yeah, the nose and ears. Yeah, not happy. The other one I'm happy with. The nose is getting there. This one will get there eventually. But if you can get them right, you get the hair right. Well, keep on tipping. Hey, Fanula. I thought I had this done. What I did the other side and what I did on the skull. What's difficult with Beckett, just speaking of his hair, you never see Beckett bald. He always had a fine head of hair on and a fine do. Oh, you can see it. It's up there. That was so distinctive. And what you have to do is try and figure out in your head from reference what's the shape of the skull look like? Because I know, cool tune. You have to figure out what shape the skull is and sculpt it. I don't necessarily think that I don't know. Look at Beckett's skull. I don't know. The general proportions are right, and I've been using a skull to help me with that. And it's not bad. There's a few areas that need working with, it's very different. I've done two types of courses. One where it's literally just character sculpting, and with the character sculpting, we sculpt hair. Whereas when we're doing the other sort of creatures and monsters on the silicone bust course, that you have to sculpt it with no without hair, and usually reference it has hair, so especially he does. So then you need another source of reference, and that is skull. What type of hair? I probably are going to use yak, because yak. Well, the yak I have is far stronger than the horse, and it's a little bit thicker as well, and I think would work well for this scale. I also have it. Jesus, figs matter. I haven't seen you in I don't know how long. So what else are we sculpting, lads? Or what should I say, what else are we creating? Because people are not necessarily sculpting. They're creating all sorts of stuff. The fabric, the plaster. Yeah, what's yeah? What the hell is a yak? I think, you get them in India, the ones that the research that I've had is they're from Tibet. And it looks like a hairy cow. And that's what it's a coarse hair. That's where you get yak hair from, an actual yak. Now, this here is bothering me. This armature, I'm gonna have to lob off a bit because it's do it's wrong, and it's doing things to my scope that I don't want it to do. So I'm gonna do that. I don't have any electrical tools to do that. Maybe just a saw. You're making raccoons. Like, okay, what? Explain that to me now, Kathy. You're making a raccoon. So again, you're going to make, I presume, that a skull, and then pop it out in mold it in silicone and then pop it out in resin. So, oh, Kathy, you're making raccoons made out of fabric. Whoa. I've nearly done that. I've nearly knocked them over. Momo, what's the story? And I tell you, if he falls down, he's going through the floor because he weighs a ton. Never use this mentally on that. If you're prepping totem poles for some resin work, what's that mean? That's cryptic. But I have stopped. Well, my wife hasn't, but stopped listening to news. I'm in a complete bubble and ether. Don't know what's going on. I know, Paddy, I'm better for it, but I suppose I probably should be still a bit informed. But you're wholly prepared for the apocalypse, seeing as you've made those axes. If anybody hasn't seen this, you have to go to Paddy's. Is it in Instagram, Paddy? He's made axes and throwing axes. Another. He was a famous trumpet from all Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone. You carved massive torque poles and now gotcha. So you've actually made the torque pole. So you're just finishing it off. Oh, finishing it with glowing resin. Cool. Because the next day the cat went out and drafted the band and all the company jumps when he plays Reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. I'm generally, well, I'm thinking, maybe other people have a different opinion. I'm sure there's loads of out there, but I'm generally an optimistic type person, and generally, and I don't let this sort of stuff get in me. I just get on with it and do something. The last couple of days I'm going, this is weird, I'm knackered, I don't know why I'm knackered, I'm going out for walks, it's just a bit bizarre, it's not normal, yeah, so I get the slump, glow in the dark, is it glow in the dark, Aoife? You can get glow in the dark, there's a cool product. I haven't figured out I know how to use it, but I haven't figured out something to use it on. And it's from Smooth On, it's called Glow Worm, and it will glow in the dark. It's powder, so you mix it with resin, or you mix it with you can mix it with silicone as well. And there's another dye called Ignite, and you can mix the sort of them together. It gives you a really, really cool effect, a warm glow. So, Claudia, you're doing a show. Well, you're hopefully doing a show, okay? But Claudia, that makes perfect sense. Momo, what are you smoking? You must be doing something. Now, this tool here, that's what the whole of his head, well, apart from the face, is that there. From what I'm using the bandsaw blade part, the aggressive sharp part. It just makes it beautiful and smooth and gets all the divots out. She says it is glow in the dark, so it's a totem pole with glow in the dark resin. How cool is that? So I thought we'd go with the crooners today, lads. No, yeah, there's some glow in the dark you have to charge, and this one seemingly it doesn't. I haven't used it, so I can't really speak for it. But it looks stunning. Glow warm. Hey, you, Tommy. Catherine Michaels would love to make a DJ booth and have some of it glow in the dark. So, Aoife, there you go. You could help her out. I'm sure Ali would be well into doing something like that as well. You're not particularly seeing a nice view, lads. I understand. It's just need to get this done. I didn't know this was coming out, but has anybody seen Pinocchio? Not the stop motion. There's a stop motion coming out with Del Toro, but there's a live action one coming out, and Mark Collier. Did all the, well, it started with Walter Adams, did all the sort of, what do you call it, test makeups, but it went to Mark Collier in the end. But has anybody seen it? Yeah, I've seen the pictures for it myself, and it looks pretty savage. Savage, but I haven't seen it. I didn't even know that it was being made. Some sculpts. Now, this is not going to be just finished in clay, so it's going to silicone. Some sculpts, I absolutely love the tool marks on them. Good morning. just twist this around a bit so you can see less of me, more of it. Yeah, what's mad, man, and it never ceases to amaze me, doing this and yapping. 50 minutes have gone. Like we're sitting here for 50 minutes. So what I would say is, and I keep saying it because I sometimes don't make it in time. Instagram, but 10 minutes left on Instagram, I think. Thank you very much for tuning in. If you probably noticed, Marcus have sort of jumped on board and they sort of like what I'm doing or trying to do. And they're sort of promoting it and getting it out there. You know, can people sculpt or can people just, you know, hang out for an hour and, you know, be creative, make stuff. It'd be great if people shared it out. Share your stuff. Show people what you're making. And inspire people to you know, get up off your bums and make something. Because I don't know, lads, but it looks like we're here for a wee while. We need to keep ourselves sane. So share it out there. And let's get as many people either being sculpting or being creative in some way. As I said, I will be here every Wednesday and every Saturday at 3. Now next Wednesday, Damien asked me to make punching needle, and that's what I'm going to do next Wednesday. So if you're interested in seeing how, now I don't have a lot of hair, and there's things I don't have because it's still, Mar, what's the story? There's a lot of stuff I don't have. It's still in college, but he asked will I make a punching needle for hair. So I will be doing that on this. I will be punching hair into it. So I know I have needles there. I go through all of that on Wednesday, but that's what I'm going to do next Wednesday at 3. I'm going to, you'll see the sample that I made on Friday, the silicone painting. And I'll show you how to do hair punching. And I know there's a few people who are tuned in that might want to refresh on that a bit, but that's what I'm going to do, and then I'll re-engage with sculpting this fella the following Saturday. So as I said before, if there's stuff that people want a tutorial on or want me to talk about, as I said, I don't know everything that, but and I can't do everything, especially at the minute, but I can't do everything anyway, but let me know and we will try and get something together and do a demo. I speak your name in my every what can be difficult at this size, like I've done big stuff before, like with Marcus, the last one was Maria Santos, her head, but essentially when I sculpted out of polystyrene, and the way you buy the polystyrene is in a massive block, and that block is 12 feet by 4.5 feet by 4 foot by 3.5 feet, and her head was 4 feet by 3.5, it was essentially nearly a quarter of a block. It was huge. So the problem with the size at this age, if with fat or with muscle or with a wrinkle, the line of it can easily go off very, very quickly. And if you don't notice it, it's a fairly big mistake. And trying to pull back from that, it can be quite hard to do. Not impossible. With this, it's not impossible at all. You can just add clay on or take it off. With poly, it's all, mostly all reductive. It's like carving you carve into. It's not that you build on top of like this stuff. Like I do both. I build on top and carve in. But with polystyrene, if you make a mistake, if you take too much off, it's gone. I think Paddy Hine would contest to that. So, everybody on Instagram, thank you for joining. As I said, share it out. I will be here every Wednesday, and until this messiness is over. I'm going to continue on trying to sculpt this fella. And if there are requests for tutorials, send me a message. Think about it. Don't have to tell me now. Send me a message, and we will. I'll try and do some sort of tutorial of it. As I said, I'm in the playroom at the minute, and materials are limited, but not too limited. Might be able to do stuff. So I'm going to do hair punching next week. So I think you, yeah, there's a few minutes left. So if I don't say goodbye, thank to Instagram. Thank you all for tuning in. And if you want to hop over to Facebook, I'm going to be there for a wee bit longer. I want to get a little bit more done on this. Just Instagram doesn't let me do over an hour. Mad the things to learn with all of this social media that I never even thought or never wanted or needed. That's the truth. Now, what you have to appreciate is, these are all probably at home. I don't know, people might be on their own, people might not be, but I have a wife and two kids next door, and they've been really quiet, so that the, they don't interrupt. So it's a big thank you to them as well that I can actually do stuff like this. Well, without them, I wouldn't be able to do it all. Great tune to sign out of Instagram. Absolutely. Yeah, you think I planned that? A tune that I want played at my every cut. So once I get this big fat in there and the wrinkles on an angle of walk instrument. So Instagram, it's been a pleasure, and again, if you want me to do tutorials on whatever, I'll tell you if I can't, and let me know, and I'll set something up. If I don't know if Damien there, I don't know if he's here. If people know Damien, he's in 4 years, tell him I'm doing hair punching on Wednesday, and we can talk about the silicones and all that sort of stuff then as well. So might not just do all the sculpting, but every Wednesday and every Saturday you have a bit of fun to talk about other stuff and actually do some other things. So I'm gonna stop talking and keep on sculpting, but I'll say goodbye to Instagram because time is nearly up, and thank you. I'm very grateful, people. I can't tell you is that it like you're tuning in, and hopefully it's doing something, for giving you something. But it's great for me as well to be able to chat with you and with people I know, and people I don't know, and people ask questions. Because at the minute it's a bit weird not being able to talk to anybody. Other than yourself in the morning. So Instagram, you have 30 seconds. Is there anything you want to say? Quick now. No, Instagram are gone, unfortunately. Facebook, you're stuck with me for a wee while. I'm going to keep on going for a wee while. Bizarrely, and I never thought this would happen. I'm talking to somebody, initial talk about doing an interview. So I'll be talking to Rebecca straight after this. So I'm going to keep on working for a wee while. I don't know if Rebecca's there, is she? Thank you. It's a Felida. I think that's how you pronounce your name. I'm sorry, lads. I'm awful at people's names, but I think that's how you pronounce it. I'll be here Wednesdays and Saturdays at 3 on Facebook, Instagram, and on the website on mcdonalddesign.com. So I think, lads, we all moving over from Instagram to Facebook, are we? The only reason I set up, I was going to do it all on Facebook because it's actually a lot easier to do it on Facebook. But the people were saying, oh, no, don't do that. We don't have Facebook. We just have Instagram. And then I had people saying, oh, I don't have either. Can you do something? And so that's why it's on the website. Ah, Jesus, Jessica. Come on. So Jessica, give me a shout. I'm here all week. And the next week. And the next week. I have one diehard on, and I think I know who that is, on YouTube. And I just want to say thank you very much for tuning in. And pretty much it was made for you going up on the website. So. It's amazing actually at the minute, the amount of lives, things that are going out live from people who are like savage sculptors, savage makeup artists, artists in general, singers, and actors, you name it, everybody's sort of getting on it and just, you know, doing all sorts of mad stuff. Brilliant. I think it's great. Last night I was listening to a daughter and her father singing a tune from Greatest Showman. I thought it was brilliant, absolutely brilliant. I have to say, Jessica, I look forward to doing this too. It's pretty weird sitting in your ex-kid's playroom, and that's been turned into pretty much a studio. And now, what you see is that wall there, and that wall there. Let me see. Just want to loosen that a bit. That wall there has Beckett and all you can see is this gut. You can't see the crap on the floor and you can't see the crap outside. It's an absolute mess. But I look forward to doing this too. It's nice to have a connection with people. And if you can get as many people sculpting or even just distracted for a wee while. That's why I started doing this. Now it is surprising But surprising, but it's a good thing. And the amount of time that you will spend on form, the detail, yes, but the form is something that you have to spend an awful lot of time on. Don't point and go on to detail. And there's a few people out there that you know, they're probably feeling wrapping their knuckles, form, then detail. Hi, Fnula. Oh my goodness. Oh. Yeah, this texture that I was literally just looking in the mirror, and it goes up this level where it shouldn't really follow around because this is pushing up and up and up and up. I can make this out. Now, I don't know, but this happened to me already. I got a message off Facebook saying that this part of your, because I shared live, and some people don't get to see it at 3 o'clock, and it said that this part of your video will be muted because of copyright issues. So I don't know if a whole lot of this is going to be muted because of me playing Frank Sinatra. Now, I was listening to a dude, what's his name, Stuart Bray, and he's a brilliant sculptor. He really is a fantastic makeup artist as well. I don't know him, but he seems like he's a very nice person. He was just talking about sculpting, and it's like, it's sort of my philosophy about lots of things, it's, whether it's design or, you know, a blank page, blank wall, blank sketchbook, or an armature that has no clay on it whatsoever, very intimidating, very daunting, and the only mistake that you really make is just not starting. Like, if you start and then you get into this, you will get into this cult. Now, people will talk about it being good or bad. Does that really matter that it's good or bad? I don't think so. At the start of sculpting, it might not be good, but the most important thing is that you started. And what will make it good is practice, reference, sort of getting a grip on your ego, and learning from people who are far better than you. Learning from people who are learning. Like, it's a strange thing. In college, you are supposed to be the guru of all fountain of knowledge, and I'm not. The amount of times that I've learned stuff of people who are learning is ridiculous. It's pretty, absolutely brilliant. And if you're learning for learning's sake, it's sort of, it's innocent, it's sort of, none, it just is what it is. And once you can get in on that and be with it and let the ego and let the negative voice in your head saying that's crap, you can't do this, just go at it. But no, I'm going to learn, I'm going to try and learn, I'm going to spend a bit of time. Biggest thing you need to do is you need to start. If you don't start, then you didn't start, it didn't happen.
left alone, singing the blues and crying. You treat me coldly each day in the year. You
I've heard this, the first draft is perfect and the only job is to exist. Yeah,
it must just be
do it. And what's bizarre about that, I'm reading the book at the minute, and it's about this sort of stuff. I love this sort of creativity, and I love that. And it's like an elixir, creativity, and you're trying to figure out what's the formula, how do we get better at this, and but I call it bottle it, because if I could bottle it, I'd be a lot more, I'd have a lot more money than you know. But the what is it? What's the name of the book? Oh yeah, Creativity Inc. By Ed, I think it's Ed Mullins. I think that's his name. But anyway, he's the founder and creator of Pixar. And what I find fascinating in it is that they, I assume everybody has seen Up. The main character in the movie Up. And what's wonderful about it is that they go into the how the story started, and everybody knows the story. It's about this old dude. Well, just if you don't, I'm going to make do a spoiler alert. This old dude massively in love with his wife. His wife unfortunately dies, and he goes on this mad adventure that the two of them are supposed to go on. And attaches a rake balloon to his house, but the house flies away. But when you actually read the book and you find out about the creative process that was involved in it, it originally was about two brothers who lived in a castle up in a cloud. And that castle, there are two brothers. Were vying for to rule the kingdom. They're nasty to each other, and they fall off and into this down onto the planet Earth. That's where it started. And then there was four reiterations of it, later and later and later, and it completely changed. The story completely changed. It didn't end up the same, but it started. It started with one story. And I'm reading this, and it's going on for about four pages. And what's amazing is that, what is amazing is what was allowed to happen was there was an inkling of an idea, and it was more a feeling, but there was no story. And but the idea was not snuffed out when it wasn't working. It wasn't said that it was a failure. What it actually did. Was they allowed that story to kindle and become something else. And when you read the book and knowing the cartoon, you're going, this is the beginning, and this is how it started, and it ended up nothing, nothing like what I ended up at the end. And a beautiful film. The creative process was just allowed to flourish. Sorry, that was just rambling. Now, what I would love is to be able to get right in there and just start below Adam's apple and above the stern, but I can't because that armature is in the wrong place. I know it's not particularly interesting this week, looking at the back of his head, but it has to be done. Now, I don't know what Beckett's back of his head looks like. I don't know what his back of his ear looks like either. So what I find brilliant, this cost me about a tenner, I think. And you can see what the back of the ear looks like in that. I'm going, well, if it's good enough for that, it's good enough for Beckett. So that's what I've been using for reference. And then going out a little bit as well. But resonance. And do whatever. Now, what I want as well, and I want, I am going to work at these ears. The other one I really have to work on. But I am going to work at them. And when eventually it goes into silicone, what I really want is, and that's in the nostrils and on the ears as well, is the I want the light to be able to travel through, and you will be able to, you know, when you see that torch going through your hand, that effect of seeing light going through skin. That's what I want on the ears, and all those sort of, you know, really stupid details. That's what's going to make this look really real. Now, what I hope doesn't happen is that this doesn't just dive bomb into the uncanny valley. I assume everybody knows what the uncanny valley is. And everybody looking at it will have an on-eerie feeling. I'm sculpting an ear at the moment, and I was literally just thinking, Jesus, what does the back of the ear look like? Well, there's this shape here. You can see that it goes very shallow U. So it goes like that. And then it scoops back in the middle. But this bit here is always there. And if you feel it, it is the back of the ear. It's always there. Can you see that? This bit here. Now that's a bit big. Still, I'm going to work at it to get that a little bit smaller. There will be, you can see there's a start of wrinkles going on in here. And it sort of folds in on itself. So that's what the back of the ear looks like. But and it's actually very hard to get reference that shows you the back of the ear, because what photographer's going to take the back of the ear? Whereas those little sculpturing reference things are really... Yeah, the uncanny valley, not our friend. And if it lobs off into the uncanny valley, that can be something that works for you. It works for an artist called Patricia Piccini. And Patricia Piccini, she loves to just dive bomb into the uncanny valley. She will purposely create creatures that are sort of hybrids between human and animals. And she loves to create that feeling. But then you're looking at somebody like Sam Jinks, who I would think doesn't want to create that feeling, and purposely made his figures, I would think, now not talking to him, I would say that this is the reason why he made them. I think they're, Claude, what size is it? You know what they are. I think they're a third or a two-thirds scale, so that when we're looking at them, we don't get an eerie feeling. They're not absolutely human size, so we don't feel uncomfortable. Well, the majority of people don't feel uncomfortable by looking at it. So hopefully Mr. Beckett doesn't fall into the uncanny valley trap. Again, more ramblings. Now, I have about 10 minutes left, lads, and I have to. I actually haven't been outside, I'd say 2 kilometers outside my house in 3 weeks. Or I actually don't know how long we're here. But I have to go and get shopping. So, I'll be there. And what you also don't see is the mess that's on the floor. Look at that too. So this here will follow the back of the ear, and you can feel it, and you can feel how thin it is. So this here will follow this. See that shape there? That is the back, and in here is the back, that there. So it is, it's too, this is too big at the minute, so I'm going to just make them smaller. So, lads, I'm nearly finished with you, and if you enjoy tuning in, let me know. If there's things I can change, let me know. If there's tutorials or things that you would like to know, if I can do them, I will. Let me know what they are. I'm going to do hair punching next week. We'll talk about silicone as well. That might not be interesting to everybody, but somebody has asked, so I'm going to do it. If you like what I'm doing, share it out there. Let's try and get as many people sculpting and creating stuff as possible. Oh, thanks to my patient family as well. Absolutely. Well, what if then none of this happens at all? So I have 9 minutes. So any questions before we finish up today, lads? I hope everybody is well. I hope everybody's staying sane and safe. Don't be doing stupid things. Stay at home. I see it on YouTube, or not YouTube, but Facebook. Just people that stupid things, for Christ's sake. We're all doing this for a reason. The eye. Okay, hold on a second. This is Shane. Let me see. Where did you go, Shane? The eyes. The reason why the eye is so difficult, and the reason why it goes into the uncanny valley, or that weird place, is that we're trying to do something that is extremely difficult to do. Replicate a human face. Now, we're talking something that I've done a lot of research on, and did my thesis on the uncanny valley. And we're talking about eons, like millennia, we're going back to caveman, the reason the uncanny valley sort of exists, or the reason why they think it exists, it was coined by a dude called Mori, a Japanese roboticist. And if you see somebody, or did see somebody when you were caveman, that they were sick, clammy skin, their eyes were not right, we used sign language back then. We didn't use a language per se, and so we used facial recognition of the features on the face to recognize if somebody was an enemy, if somebody was sick, if somebody was aggressive. Same things we would know today, but a lot more back then. And we would look at somebody and say, well, that person is sick, or a clammy skin, they're sick. We're not. We're going to alienate them and put them up, keep them away, so we don't get sick. That's how basic it is. Now, when you look at the uncanny valley and you look at stuff like, let me see, Polar Express, and we're looking at CG has fallen into that trap an awful lot. And when you fall into the uncanny valley, what happens is that on those cases, is that they look zombie-like. It's in the eyes, it's in the pallor of the skin, and it's absolutely in the eyes. It's always in the eyes, and that's why you get that feeling inside you, don't like that, or I know that's not real, or I'm a little bit uncomfortable. It goes back to caveman time. So trying to do an eye, is that, and all those little bits of details, and especially around the mouth, are the most two difficult things to be able to do right. That now, an ear. An ear isn't actually difficult to do. An ear is easy to do as long as you follow the form and shape. And what's it called? What the hell is that called? Leonardo da Vinci coined it. And we know that the perfect. What the hell's it called? The perfect ratio, the golden ratio. An ear is that. So once you follow that, it's perfect. This eyes and lips are hard, but we can talk about that too. Jesus, Shane, that's not going to be an easy one. What's a really, really helpful things if you want to do eyes, and I want to get a few of them, is somebody who was absolutely fantastic at eyes was Michelangelo. And you can get replicas. Some of them are sculpted. Some of them are actually replicas of his eyes, his nose, and his lips. And what's really useful is, and they're oversized, so you can see what the facets are, what skin goes on top, what skin goes underneath. So that would be useful. Another thing would be is getting a life cast of something and actually studying it and trying to replicate it. But yeah, I look up the name of what it's called. It's a specific name for those eyes, and I'll send it to you.
I know I will never stop.
Yeah, Botox is the same thing. If you see somebody with Botox and you say, that's not real, something wrong there. There is something wrong there because you're used to seeing all those little movements. That's how you tell if somebody's going to kill you or somebody's going to be friendly to you, or you know, that's how we're built. So if we can't see that, we're going, something wrong here. So I have 3 minutes, and then I'm getting in my car, which is bizarre. I haven't been in my car in weeks. So Jessica, I am here more than so if you want to give me a shout.
I know I will never
stop. After a while, Lizzie, you can't even figure out what the hell you're looking at. No, with eyes, I'm not happy with that. I'm absolutely not happy with that. It's terrible. But you have to go back to the principles and looking at what do you call it? Reference. Wow, a Botox party. So I've a few minutes left, lads. So Shane, I'll have to work on that. Anybody else want anything specific? Doesn't have to be with sculpting. Could be model making stuff as well. I'll try and do. Well, you tell me, and I'll tell you if I can or cannot do that. The other thing with references, it's like a clamp, compass. Trust the reference. If the measurements aren't the same and your sculpt's on the reference, your sculpt's wrong. So always trust the reference. Can you add clay to what you have done? What does that mean, Captain? Sorry. Can I add clay to this? I'm doing that all the time. So I can, yeah. Is that what you're saying to me? dude. Amateur making. Explain that. Are you talking about stop motion? You're talking about full size puppets? Because we could do some stop motion, all right. Yeah, if Catherine, I'm adding clay onto this all the time, so it's not just a carving process. It's an additive process, but I do carve into it at times as well. So Brian, if puppetry, well, there's it depends on how complicated you want to be, but there's simple mechanism for like live puppetry, but then my issue is I have no machines. If it's stop motion, I have a bucket load of stop motiony stuff here, and we could go through stuff. Right, lads. So it's been a pleasure. YouTube, thank you very much for sticking with me. One person. Thank you very much for sticking. Lads, it's your last chance to ask me. Can I do something? Today, if you come on, think of something, send me a message or something. But thank you very much for tapping in. This is as good for me as it is for you. What a tune. So with that, I'm gonna say, oh, let me see. We are planning on making rod puppets in the future. Well, is it like Bronis? The puppets that they made, because the mechanism that they use, we could I've no machines, but we could talk about it and we could draw it out, and we could talk about the like each joint, how I would do it or why and why I would do it that way, and to be honest, they're the same sort of joints that you would do in mocking some massive stuff, so we could do something like that. Leave that with me. Yeah, cool. Leave it with me, and I'll try and put something together. But slán, and keep safe, keep well, lads, and I'll see you next Wednesday. Share it, like it, comment on it, and tell me what you like, what you don't like, or what you'd like changed, or what you'd like me to do as a demo. If I'm not doing anything, I'm going to be doing him. Thanks for tuning in. Bye bye now. And the curtain is gone.